Hello everybody, this is Digital Blackboard by Sachin P. Nagamote. In this video, we will discuss about equivalent of parallel combination of ideal voltage source and ideal current source. So here we can see an ideal current source and an ideal voltage source are connected in parallel. So we will find out what will be the total voltage or equivalent voltage across terminals A and B. So as this is an ideal voltage source, so its internal impedance will be zero, and as this is an ideal current source, so its internal impedance will be infinite. So let ZV is the internal impedance of ideal voltage source, so it is zero, and let ZI is the internal impedance of ideal current source, so it's infinite. So we are having the values of ZV and ZI, that is internal impedance of ideal voltage source and ideal current source respectively. Now let us find what will be the total or equivalent voltage. So by Ohm's law, V is equal to I into Z. So total or equivalent voltage VEQ will be equivalent current IEQ into equivalent impedance ZEQ. Now let us find the values for IEQ and ZEQ. Now we know that equivalent current or total current will be the sum of these two currents, that is current from ideal current source and current from ideal voltage source. So the current from ideal current source is already known to us, that is I of t. But what will be the current of this ideal voltage source? How much current will flow through this ideal voltage source, that we don't know. So we will use the formula. So according to again Ohm's law, I is equal to V by Z. So V of this voltage of this voltage source is given, that is V of t, and Z, that is internal impedance of this voltage source, is ZV. So this current of this voltage source will be V of t upon ZV. So this is the equivalent current or total current. Now let us find out the equivalent impedance. So we know that this ZV and ZI are the internal impedances of ideal voltage source and ideal current source, which are connected in parallel. So we have to take its parallel combination. So equivalent impedance will be ZV into ZI upon ZV plus ZI. That is the parallel combination of two impedances. Okay. So now we can easily find out the VEQ. Now VEQ will be equal to IEQ into ZEQ. So we are putting the values. Okay. Now let us arrange this term here. If we take LCM as ZV, so it will become I of t into ZV plus V of t upon ZV. Into ZEQ is already known, that is ZV into ZI upon ZV plus ZI. Now from this expression we can cancel this ZV and this ZV. So ZV and ZV will get cancelled. So VEQ will be equal to ZV and ZV. After getting ZV and ZV cancelled, VEQ will be equal to I of t into ZV plus V of t into ZI upon ZV plus ZI. Okay. Now we will put the limits. Okay. Now we are having the limit, that is ZV tends to 0 and ZI tends to infinity. So we are putting the limits here, ZV tending to 0 and ZI tending to infinity. So after putting the limit, instead of ZV we can write down 0, and instead of ZI we can write down infinite. Okay. So it will become I of t into 0 plus V of t into infinity upon 0 plus infinity. So 0 plus infinity will get infinity only. So this infinity and infinity will get cancelled, then this I of t into 0 will be 0, and only the term of V of t will be there, and that is why VEQ will be equal to only V of t. So VEQ is equal to only V of t. So from this derivation we came to know that if an ideal current source and ideal voltage source are connected in parallel, so the equivalent voltage is nothing but because of only an ideal voltage source. It means this I of t, that is ideal current source, can be removed, or it can be termed as dummy. Okay. So equivalent of parallel combination of ideal current source and ideal voltage source will be only an ideal voltage source. Okay. So I hope you understood this topic very well. So please like, share and subscribe Digital Blackboard. Thank you very much.